This week on Maker Update, a new take on stage lighting, a remote-controlled smoke grenade, homebrew Sofubi, and I want my cat TV. Hello and welcome back to Maker Update, the show where we keep you up to date on all the cool things that makers are making. I'm Tyler Weingartner, and I hope you're all doing great. We've got an awesome show for you full of great projects, so let's check out the project of the week. Sometimes you just get a really bright idea. Okay, that's a really terrible pun. But what isn't terrible is Pedal, this portable, open source, customizable stage lighting rig by Super Valid Designs. This is actually the second version of this project, with a new programmable backend based on the popular WLED firmware, and a ton of really clever design considerations. Let's get into it. First up, I love that each lighting element is based around its own cable reel. You plug it into the base station, unwind it to its desired location, and then the spool becomes the base of the lighting tower. The design of the spool is made with the mechanics of unspooling in mind. The lighting elements inside each of these tubes are a little new to me. These are WS2811 COB strips. They're incredibly dense and they have a good amount of diffusion built right into their weather sealing. They also require 24 volts, but that's a considered change from the previous version. Higher voltage means lower current, and lower current means they can use thinner cable to do the same job, which means you can fit longer cables on each spool. The walls of each spool is made of laser or water jet cut aluminum, and the waste cut of one side of the spool becomes the other side. And while we mentioned that the primary interface for this is WLED, which is great for quick addressable setups, there's a whole software backend that lets you program your whole lighting setup in a variety of ways, either queuing through your DAW software, or reacting to media inputs, or leaving the door open to reacting to your own programmed inputs. I also really love seeing some of these alternate lighting setups, like making a studio lighting fixture out of a cake pan. Now, where have I seen that before? Anyhow, check out the link down in the description for more details on this project. More projects. Have you ever caught your feline friend being just as invested in the show you're watching as you are? Becky Stern did, and that's why she built this tiny TV for her fuzzy buddies. This project is essentially a Raspberry Pi hooked up to a 5-inch HDMI touchscreen display in a custom enclosure. The Raspberry Pi automatically connects to her cat's favorite YouTube channel, which displays pretty much an endless stream of birds and squirrels. But there's a lot of cool design consideration for the 3D printed enclosure to keep the Pi cool. And one amusing aside, the cats kept batting at the touchscreen and pausing the video. So she needed to replace the cable with a charge-only cable to sever the data connection. It's a super cute video, so check it out. Okay, so here's one for you. Have you ever been asked to create a remote control smoke grenade? Probably not. But Backhaul Studios has, and they're sharing their project with you. This is an ask for an upcoming film project, and they needed the smoke grenade to land on a specific mark every single take. The resulting project is a remote control robot that spins the drum of the grenade from the inside, sort of like a single-axis BB-8 droid. The smoke is provided from a vape unit that he can trigger from the transmitter. It's not an earth-shattering project, but it is a really clever one, and a testament to what you can pull off on a deadline with off-the-shelf parts. You also need to check out this video from Red Bull about creating a drone to follow F1 driver Max Verstappen around the Silverstone racing circuit. I almost passed this one up because it seemed a little too corporate, but this is a proper maker story. What's nuts about this drone is that they designed it so that at full speed, it's almost fully horizontal. They even created a bullet-shaped hull to make the most of its aerodynamics. And the final footage, it's just breathtaking. And finally, we have another project from Japanese mechanical designer Karakuri, a mechanical 7-segment clock. Seriously, if you don't feel your stomach get a little wobbly as she covers the CAD overview at the start, what are you doing? What's more is that every single part of this clock is 3D printed. If that's not a testament to the fact that 3D printing has fully arrived, I don't know what is. Every mechanism in this clock is beautiful and it's a sight to behold. Time for some tips and tools. Through Hackaday, I learned about this massive upgrade from a cheap educational microscope into this engineering powerhouse by BirdBrain Engineering. They use stepper motors from scavenged CD-ROM drives to create a motorized XY table for the microscope, and a third stepper motor for the Z-axis. The new visual interface is provided by a Raspberry Pi camera, and the attached Raspberry Pi itself delivers the 1080p resolution to a full-screen monitor in their lab. This is a fascinating and expansive project, with a really satisfying conclusion. Xyla Foxlin is moving shop, and like with any shop move, this gives you the huge opportunity to rethink the way you've been organizing your workspace. A lot of this new shop is wish fulfillment for her, with a wall of Weeha and the dedicated Bodle Toad workspace. But the real party piece is her new 4x8 workbench, which she started building before she even moved all of her furniture in. There's dedicated spaces for her drills, hand tools, sandpaper, scraps, tape. This thing is nuts. We should all have something like this. Over on the YouTube channel Carl Cinema, I came across this video detailing his journey as a first AC on film sets after deciding to invest in a 3D printer. Most of this video is a showcase of how he envisioned and developed various mounting fixtures and rigs to make his work easier. But really, this is a treatise about how, when the tool you have is a 3D printer, every problem looks like a nail that can be driven in by a 3D printer. Once you get the vision in your head for the possibilities, there's not much holding you back. And finally, we have a follow-up to the Crafsman Steady Crafting video about the Sofubi process. And this week, he's trying to crack the code of doing it at home. A good chunk of this video is the creation of the character he wants to cast. He then creates a silicone mold and then a soft resin rotocast. He works through a few different resin compositions to get the right feel for the final castings. It's a really cool process. For this week's DigiKey Spotlight, we have a new video from Shawn Hymel about the Google Coral Dev Board. This is a microcontroller scale board with a tensor core right on the board, along with an onboard camera, all while using less than a single watt of power. Shawn's video takes you through his process of programming this unique board for his own computer vision-based robotics project to get the most out of it. All right, and that is gonna do it for this week's show. Thank you so much for watching. As a reminder, you can get more info about every single project you've seen here by checking out the notes down in the description. While you're there, give us a thumbs up, leave us a comment, and hit subscribe so you don't miss the next one. As always, great big thanks to DigiKey for making this whole show possible and to you for watching. Take care. We'll see you soon.